Welcome back, Professor Nick here one more time. again, with another music reaction. And the professor thing is just for BMAC. It's just an inside joke for us since I'm wearing my glasses. But welcome back to Nick and Lex. Thank you for being here. We're going to do another marathon today for BMAC. First of all, thank you, BMAC, for sponsoring the video, for requesting these amazing tracks. And I just did your other marathon earlier today, so I'm wearing the same clothes. And the background is pretty much, the lighting is fantastic today. I don't know what's different. It's usually the same camera, the same setting. It's just maybe there's not as much as light on the corner, and there's one light in the back, and that's pretty much it. So we're basically sitting in a dark room. This light over here that's pointing at me is pretty strong. So maybe I'll have to tell Alexia, maybe we should, or also maybe there's not a lot of sun out today. So sometimes that also kind of like interferes. But well, today we have a special marathon. We're going to start it off with Tommy Bolin, and I'm going to do the version that BMAC requested that is not too long. It's People People from the album Teaser. Let's see what year this is. Okay, that's wrong. 2021. They must have been like it's like a remaster. I'm sure it's from the 70s. Then we're going to do our great, amazing Jan Hammer. From, you know, Miami Vice fame, Mahavishnu Orchestra, and all the good stuff he's done by himself. We're going to do country and Eastern music. This is the album Like Children. Let's see. This is from 1974. I love it. I love the artwork. And we're going to do another track by him. This is called The Seventh Day. And the album is The First 7 Days. And this is from 1975. And I think I've done something from this album. I remember the artwork. And that's the marathon, okay? So let's start it off. Let's give it up for Tommy. And I mean, he's just such an amazing guitar player. Especially BMAC and RG request a lot of him. I'm in love with this guy. He's such a great musician, at such a young age, and he passed away too soon. I mean, it's a shame. It's just a shame. It's always sad when I listen to him, because I'm like, what could have been, you know? Like, what else could he have brought to us? But so here we go with the first track, People People. And thanks again. If this is your first time on the channel, please, you know, enjoy, comment below. You'll get a lot of love from the comment section. We're all very positive here. We have a great community. And if you like it, you can subscribe. You can give me a like or a dislike. It's all up to you. Whatever you like to do, it's, you know, whatever, like I said, what you would like to do. Okay, so let's give it up for Tommy. Let's go.
Brother, brother, help me, please. I'm as lonely I can be. All me friends are scaring me. But if you forget me, then I will be. Yeah. What can I do? I'm in love with Tootsie too. Please excuse me if I am low.
so good. It almost has like a little bit of a reggae vibe. I love the sax, the singing. It's a great track, man. I mean, you can't go wrong with Tommy. It's just great music and great interplay. I loved how you could hear like the channels opening up to all the different instruments. It's just like more antique than now. You don't hear those things anymore. Or in the remasters, they're like gone. And I think I like that. I like to listen when something opens up, when a mic goes up. And I don't know, maybe it's just me. But yeah, really cool. Let's see. I love this. That's like the feel that I'm getting, that a little bit of a I could totally be wrong, but I'm getting a little bit of a vibe here. Like, I love it though. Really cool. I was totally off. Sorry for interrupting. Just hearing like the backing track, and yeah, A little bit like that. Let me back up a little bit. You can't see it anyways. You have to like literally go to the middle of the room. Enough. But BMAC does enjoy when I take out the guitar, so you know, certain liberties. Thank you. Okay, now we'll have Mr. Jan. I always want to say, of course, Jan, but it's he is, you know, European, and so it's Jan. And then hammer, I think, is hammer, but it's hammer. Let's just say hammer. But we're going to do country and Eastern music. And I love also BMAC. He helps me a lot with if I pronounce something wrong. And don't think for one second that I would take that in any negative way. On the contrary, I love constructive criticism. And if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. And, you know, there's a lot of names here that I've never pronounced some. I think the last one, what was super surprised was when I did the Oxygen of, let me see, I have to look it up because it is, the name was, the Jean-Michel, and then I said Jarret, but it's Jar, because it's, you're right. In French, you don't pronounce the E. So it's Jarre. Jean-Michel Jarre. And then, and I was like, oh my God, yes, BMAC, he got it right. So, and also I'm, you know, I know you, a lot of you guys speak multiple languages, so I do appreciate it. Don't think for one instance or second that I would be like, oh, no, no, on the contrary, I love constructive, I love correction, and Alexia does it all the time. Like, I have a funny way of saying stuff sometimes because my first language is not English, and then if I say something, she just giggled, but she loves it. Or sometimes I come up with words that I've never said, like, oh, this was like, I was flabbergasted, and she's like, flabbergasted? What did you hear that, you know? So it's really funny for her that when I come up with new words and I use them in like, so, yeah. So, okay, next song, we got country and Eastern music. Here we go.
Thank you.
here you can really hear, like, I'm so happy that this was another request from BMAC that I didn't know, like, that they had worked together. I just would always listen to Aldi Miola, and I was like, wow, the keyboard player on this is insane. And now, it's not always him, but on the records that the wheel, like the, that's him, you know, and you can hear it here, like, quite a lot that's his style, you know. I always thought it was like Chick Corea because they worked together before, but it was always Jan. Not always, but a lot of times. And in that era, in the 70s era of Aldi Miola stuff, like his first album, Land of the Midnight Sun, and then Elegant Gypsy, and then all the stuff after, until a certain point, is very proggy and fusiony, and then it becomes more like world music. But I love it all. I've heard a lot of Aldi Miola in my life, so that's like stuff that I can't really react to because I've heard it all. But I think until like 2000, and I stopped there. But I started to listen to Aldi Miola like 2000. Or maybe let's say 99 to 2000 something. And then the new stuff that he was coming out with was not as interesting at the time, but I could go back. But yeah, I just love the playing, and I love that he has the same style, this fusion here, like the doo-dum, like the guitar suddenly comes in and it gets really heavy. And I like that. It's like he can do it all. It's like he can do a rock song, just trippy music, something very serene and beautiful. It's like he's so versatile. Keep on grinning, burn the meat right off your bone. It will pay off. Happiness is what you want, isn't it? Thank you. cool. Now the violin, I don't know if it was Jean-Luc Ponty or the other. I don't remember his name right now. I'm sorry. Please don't kill me. Benny something. But I've seen him before. I've seen him play live with Mahavishnu Orchestra. Maybe that's the guy on this record. Now, one thing that just popped up, maybe I made a weird face. It says YouTube copyright claim. And then it says, and I saved it under BMAC Marathon. It says, your video has been blocked. And then it says, in some countries, you know, and I'm like, oh my God. And it only said Russia. Good thing we don't live in Russia. So this happens every day. Every day when I do videos, YouTube is just brutal. Like, sometimes I have to wait a couple of days for them to get unblocked. Sometimes they don't unblock at all. It's just insane. I don't know. I don't know what we're going to do in the future. And I mean, this is only going to get worse. Someday the reactors were going to have to look for a different, you know, platform. Because, I mean, but I understand, you know, I understand it says copyright content. And then claimed by SME, Sony Music Entertainment. So it's not even the artist, it's the record company. And they just blocked it in Russia. So obviously, there's no way we can earn any money off this. Not even the artists. I mean, they claimed it. Like, not even Steve Hackett is making money. Only the record company. So, that's a bummer. Well, this was a great song. I loved it. I loved it. The whole interplay with the string instruments, and then how it just got gradually heavier, and then it got totally crazy. I love this guy. He's so talented, and it's such a shame that he's only known for, like, if you click on his name, it's like, I think the Miami Vice theme pops up. Yeah, Crockett's theme, original Miami Vice. Like, come on, man. I mean, yes, 44 million reproductions. But, I mean, the good stuff is, like, he doesn't get any credit for. Okay, we're going to do the seventh day, and that will be the end of the marathon. And let's see if that one gets blocked, too. I hope it, if it gets blocked, only in Russia. Even though everyone deserves to listen to music, I mean, even if they're invading other countries, which is, I mean, I don't know the situation. I really don't watch the news that much. I'm very ignorant when it comes to that. And I don't talk about politics ever. So that's like, so excuse my ignorance, but I just know the conflict that's going on, and that there's a lot of sanctions, and maybe they're sanctioning them also with music content. So yeah. Okay, so seventh day, and here we go. Thank you. he's using is so pleasing to the ear. I know it's old, but I don't care. I love this effect on the keyboard. It just sounds so much better than just using normal distortion or like Jordan Rudess. I think when he uses the piano, the grand piano sound, sounds amazing. But then when he goes into his like solos, he just sounds too much like a guitar. And then why have, if we have an amazing pianist like he is in a band like Dream Theater, why just imitate an electric guitar? Just, that's why I like Derek Sherinian and Kevin Moore more, because they sounded like a keyboard, not another electric guitar. It's just my opinion. Don't crucify me, please. Just, but yeah. So this is what I like when you have a keyboard player in a band. Make it sound like a keyboard, you know? Okay, so I unhooked myself. There we go. Okay, let's continue. Sorry for the interruption. Thank you. This was a great track. The solo, I mean, with the solo, he stole, of course, his own show. I mean, everything here is just beautiful. So, like, I mean, yeah. I mean, the word, the, like, I say the words, but the language, you know, just the scales and the, just the musical language he uses is so rich. Like, he has really, that's what I like so much about Holdsworth, that it's so, it's more like talking, you know, instead of just playing random notes. They really know what to leave ringing and what to cut short and where to silence. And, you know, it's, and we, if you look at a chart, you're like, wow, you know, I love improvisation, but with thoughts behind it, you know, not just crazy improv. Like, there, it has to have some kind of sense, you know. So, man, what a great, I mean, three great tracks by two amazing artists and different times, but awesome. Really, really awesome. Thank you so much, BMAC, again, for, you know, sticking to your style, of course, when you request these marathons. I mean, obviously you love fusion, so, and I'm a fusion guy too. So let's do something. Give me just 1 second and we'll finish it off, okay, with something. Okay, so this is going to be awesome. So I'm gonna end it off with some Alan Holdsworth. And Alan Holdsworth has some short songs, like where he basically just plays like a 10-second solo versus usually playing a two-minute, three-minute solo in his later stuff. But this is more like a, this is, you're going to enjoy this because it has a lot of musicians that you know. So this is from Metal Fatigue, Alan Holdsworth on the guitar. Let me just double check before I ruin this, because I should know this, but I'm pretty sure it's, Chad Weckerman. And, let's see. Paul Williams on the vocals, and then on the bass, Gary, on the drums, Gary Husband, ladies and gentlemen, yes, and Jimmy Johnson on bass. So, and then even Alan Pasqua on the keyboard. So just beautiful lineup. Let's go. This is Panic Station, one of the few sung Alan Holdsworth songs, and this is what I use to get people into Alan Holdsworth, because it's very, it's fusion-y, but it's not too much, and his solo is like very short, so it's like doesn't scare them off. So here we go. This is from
Those chords. What do I get? I just know.
Yeah, that's one of those songs that's very commercial, very almost and like almost like trying to be radio, but not quite. And Alan Holdsworth would get a lot of like he would say, "No, you guys are too jazz, man, for rock. You know, you're too jazz for a rock station." And then they would say, "Oh no, no, you're too jazzy." Too jazzy for a rock station, and then for a jazz station, they were too rock. Like, okay, like so, and then there were not a lot of fusion stations, I guess. So it was just hard for him. You know, he never really found success, even though he was so good and he was adored by people like Frank Zappa and basically any guitar player that you would ask right now, even the old ones, the great ones, you know, they would say Alan Holdsworth. Yeah, so, you know, McLaughlin was like, "I don't know what he's doing. I don't know what he's doing, but if I could steal it, I would." You know, like those are like quotes that are like floating around in guitar magazine, on the internet, you know, like Frank Zappa. He's like, he's the most interesting guitar player on the planet. And for Frank Zappa to say this, when he's like a wizard, he's literally a magician, Frank Zappa, for me. When I listen to Frank Zappa, I'm like, what is he doing? Like, what kind of like sorcery is this, you know? So, well, I hope you enjoyed, you know, there was some little bonus thrown in there. I hope you enjoyed. I've heard this hundreds and hundreds of times, this album. That's the album that basically made me a fan. But check out Devil Take the Hindmost. Check out In the Mystery. Everything. This is like Panic Station is really one of those songs that I just throw in like, that's like the first thing that I played to Alexia, because she's like, "Oh, this is interesting, you know, this is cool." But I wouldn't dare like start with stuff from like 16 Men of Tain because those solos are intense, you know. All right, well, guys, I hope you enjoyed. This was beautiful. Thank you so much, BMAC, for another lesson in music history with Tommy. And with Jan and some Alan Holdsworth to close it off. I hope you enjoyed. Everybody who enjoyed this, please give it a thumbs up or leave a comment, and I'll be very, very grateful for that. And thank you. See you in the next one. Take care, guys.